So last video I posted, I told you guys I was going to come out with a nice little ab workout. So this is what it is. But what I would like for you guys to do is before we get started on the ab workout is I want you to go do 30 minutes cardio of choice. So if you have a row machine, you can row, or you can go outside and go running or jogging, get some fresh air and some vitamin D from that beautiful sun. Even if you're somewhere where it's cold and it's cold out, weather, snow, it's still fun to run outside. I've done that before too, so it's beautiful. Or you can bike if you can bike outside, or you can if you have a stationary bike. I have a swim bike here at the house, so I could also hop on that. Or you can go swimming if you have a pool or have access to a pool. So just do something where you're moving and getting some blood flowing throughout your veins and through your heart for your heart health. So pick whatever you want to do for cardio choice, and then whenever you finish that, this is what we're going to be doing. So it's two rounds, 45 seconds on of work, and then 15 seconds off. So between each movement, you're just going to rest 15 seconds, and then you're moving on to the next. So one round is the oblique heel touches, then you're going to rest 15 seconds, then you're going to go to tuck ups for 45 seconds, then rest for the second 15 seconds. Then you're gonna do T crunches for 45 seconds, then rest for 15 seconds, and then flutter kicks is the last one. And then even after you finish the last one, flutter kicks, you're still resting for 15 seconds after you complete the 45 seconds of flutter kicks. So there's only 15 seconds of rest between each round. So once you rest for 15 seconds, then you're back at the top for the oblique heel touches and then going down through all the movements, all right? So you're only working for 45 seconds and then resting for 15. Something short, but it's gonna be a nice little burner on your abs. All right? So now I'm gonna show you the movements. Let's have some fun. One other thing I forgot to add is for mommies, if you're a mom and you have a baby and you usually take your baby on walks, go still outside with the stroller. Go walk with your baby on the stroller. You could also switch it up to where you run a couple minutes and then walk a couple minutes. You can switch off. So yeah, just get moving. You could also do lunges, walking lunges with the stroller if you want to switch that up with walking and walking lunges. So that's another idea for moms out there who have their kids and a stroller but still want to get moving.
It should be our righteousness if we keep these commandments. If we keep these commandments, if we keep these commandments, it should be our righteousness if we keep these commandments. Before the Lord, just the way He commanded. Trying to get my faith on a million, set my face on a mission to endure the temptation. Why? Because I want the kingdom. People think because you're chosen, it's gonna be a bed of roses. But they sadly mistaken them, be the ones in the fold. And look at my face, I ain't joking, them days of playing. It's over. All that shucking and cooning, crooning, spitting that Ebola. Death to all your emotions took us to hell, you need know it. Obadiah, verse 90, so gon' get what's coming for them. God took the saddest of children, drunk of Americanism, built them to the modest appearance. Some will be modest, Lord willing, polish the host to their wholesome, boastsome, just like you supposed it. But I'm still holding composure. Christ death exemplified the perfection of the law of Moses. God said, with him, we the coldest, boldest. Everyone cleaving.
So today I wanted to talk about ashwagandha for the health tip, and it's also known as a winter cherry, but it's an herb, and I love putting it in my smoothies or my homemade vegan ice cream. It has a lot of benefits, so I'm just going to list and talk about some of them, but go ahead and do your research on ashwagandha. For any of you who are struggling with getting sleep, this is known to promote restful sleep without that sedating effect, so I would definitely choose this over NyQuil, for example. If any of you guys started a new fitness program or just feel really tired from that new training schedule you're doing, this is also known to help increase endurance and strength. And then, another thing I wanted to point out is it helps your body manage stress. And so what I mean by that is this herb blocks the stress pathway in the brain. So therefore, it's known to reduce people who struggle with anxiety and depression. And one other thing I wanted to point out is that this doesn't just have health benefits for women, but it's also really beneficial for men. And so what I mean by that is that it helps increase the fertility and testosterone in men. So you may want to look into that as well if any of you are struggling with that, or your husband is struggling with testosterone levels, or even if you guys are trying to have children, I would look into this herb. And then last but not least, I wanted to talk about blood sugar and cortisol levels. I know some people out there struggle with having high blood sugar levels or even cortisol levels. So this herb helps decrease that. And then last but not least, it increases, it decreases inflammation in the body. So if any of you guys are struggling with any of these issues, these are just some of the benefits, but I definitely recommend for you to look this ancient herb up. You can order it in a powder already, so you can blend it in your smoothies or whatever you make. That's how I like to take my herbs sometimes, or you can even make teas. So yeah, go check that out. Last but not least, I am sharing the scripture for this video. Every time I like to share a scripture. And so we're going into Isaiah again, chapter 54. And I want you to read the whole chapter. It's such a beautiful and encouraging and comforting chapter. But it's about barren women. And it also talks about not having any fear. So I'm going to let you read the whole chapter, but I'm just going to read the first like 4 to 5 verses just so you can get a little taste of it. But I want you to read the whole chapter. So I want you to eat the whole pie. All right. So I'm not going to read it all, just the first 4 to 5 verses. Okay. So verse 1, sing, O barren, thou that didst not bear, break forth into singing and cry aloud, thou that didst not travail with child. For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married wife, said the Lord. Enlarge the place of thy tent, and let them stretch forth the curtains of thy habitations. Spare not, lengthen thy cords, and strengthen thy stakes. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left, and thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles, and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. Fear not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither be thou confounded, for thou shalt not be put to shame. For thou shalt forget the shame of thy youth, and shalt not remember the reproach of thy widowhood any more. For thy Maker is thy husband, the Lord of hosts is his name, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, the God of the whole earth, shall be called. Yeah, so that is just the first 5 verses. Yeah, so as you can tell, it's a powerful chapter. So go ahead and look that up. Read the whole chapter. It's 17 verses total. All right. Yeah, that's it for today. Please comment or share with anyone you wish. Let me know what you thought of that ab burner. And I look forward to seeing you next time, ladies. Shalom.